So I want to conclude this lesson by providing a high-level view of the Scrum process. The process is represented here, and as you can see, it's got several components. We're going to go through all of them one at a time. We're going to start with the product backlog. Product backlog is the single source of requirements for the process. They're ordered by value, risk, priority, necessity, so that all of these characteristics can be taken into account when selecting which backlog items to consider for the next iteration. It's a living list in the sense that backlog items can be added or removed, and it's normally defined, as we just said, by the product owner. In the sprint planning, what happens is that the next increment or the next sprint is defined. So basically, the backlog items of interest are selected based on the characteristics we just mentioned, value, risk, priority, and necessity. And the items are converted into tasks and estimated. So the result is the sprint backlog, which is the set of backlog items that will be completed during the next sprint. The sprint is an actual iteration of the Scrum process. It's got a main part that lasts 2 to 4 weeks. And within this main part, there are many daily Scrums that last 24 hours. So let's see how this works. A daily Scrum is typically characterized by a 15-minute meeting at the beginning of the day for the team to sync. And what happens during the meeting is that there is a discussion of the accomplishments since the last meeting. A to-do list for the next meeting is produced. And there's also an obstacle analysis. So if some problem appears, they're discussed in the daily Scrum and possible solutions are proposed. At the end of a 2-4-week cycle, there is a sprint review and retrospective. The sprint review normally consists of a 4-hour meeting. In the meeting, the product owner assesses the accomplishment for the specific sprint, and the team discusses issues that were encountered and solved. There's typically a demo of the deliverable for that sprint, and at that point, the product owner will also discuss the backlogs. And together with the team, they will decide what to do next. In the retrospective, conversely, what happens is that there is more focus on the process. So the goal of that part of the meeting is discussing possible process improvements, to identify them, and if promising improvements are identified, try to plan how to implement those improvements and use them in the next iterations. And something else that might happen at the end of a sprint is that if the product increment is good enough as reached a state in which it can be actually shipped, that will result in a release that is not just internal to show the product owner the progress, but can also be deployed and actually used in production. So one final consideration is that, as you can see, XP and Scrum are fairly similar, and that's because they're both agile development processes. So the main thing to keep in mind is that they both implement and enforce those ideas, values, practices, and characteristics than we saw when we discussed agile development processes in general.